गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक. ओके, सो टू इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैड फिनिश्ड पीरियडिक टेबल. ओके, सो टुडे वी डिस्कस एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर. वेरी वेरी सिंपल टॉपिक. ओके, सो दिस चैप्टर और दिस टॉपिक विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड इन क्लास 8. यस, सो टुडे will do according to class 9 syllabus. Okay, we'll do this atomic structure according to exam pattern only. Got it? So we'll not go into the details about the discovery of electron, proton, neutron and all. Okay, Rutherford experiment, which you have already done in class 8. It is there in your textbook. Okay, you go through once. Okay, so this will actually not that much important from your examination point of view. Okay, so today I'll give you just idea of our atomic structure. Okay, and its parts, electronic configuration, subatomic particles, orbits, nucleus. We'll discuss all that terms. Okay, so first we need to discuss about atom. What is an atom? I think all of you know, atom is the smallest unit, or you can call particle of matter. Okay, smallest unit of matter. Now, so this atom is actually made up of three, or you can divide atom into three such parts. Okay, try to understand this and try to be very clear to this. Okay, so now atom can be divided into three parts. The first part is subatomic particles. Number two is nucleus. And number three is orbits. Okay? So subatomic particles, nucleus and orbit. So you can divide atom into atom. Actually, atom is made up of these three parts. Okay. So now, as you all know, there are three subatomic particles. So number one is proton. Second is electron. And third one is neutron. Yes or no? Electron, proton, neutron is there. Okay, and nucleus is there. In the nucleus, this proton and neutrons are present. So in the nucleus, protons and neutrons are present. Okay, so the mass of the atom is entirely concentrated at the nucleus. Remember this. Mass is concentrated at it. Okay, so the mass, total mass of an atom excuse me, is concentrated where? At the nucleus. So in the nucleus there is a presence of protons and neutrons. So protons and neutrons together in the nucleus are called nucleons. What are nucleons? Nucleons are nothing but protons and neutrons together in the nucleus are called nucleons. Understood? Understood the part nucleus? Nucleus is present in an atom in which protons and neutrons are present. entire mass of the atom is concentrated at the nucleus. Okay, so the protons and neutrons in the nucleus are called nucleons. Okay, now orbit. So this electron is present in the orbit. So this orbit is outer nuclear part. This orbit is imaginary path. This is imaginary path in which electrons revolve around the nucleus. Electrons revolves around the nucleus. Okay. So orbits are the imaginary path, okay, in which electrons revolve. This is electron. Okay, electron revolves around the nucleus. So this is fixed. This is fixed path. This is what we call fixed path. And each path or each orbit, this orbit sometimes termed as cells. Okay, so this orbit or cells, each orbit or cell is associated with a certain amount of energy. Okay, that is why the cell are also called energy level. Okay, so why cells or orbits are termed energy level? Because each cell or orbit is associated with certain amount of energy. Okay, it has certain amount of energy, that is why it is called energy levels. Got it? Am I clear to you or not? Very simple. Subatomic particles, electrons, protons and neutrons are there in the atom. In the atom there is nucleus. In the nucleus, this which subatomic particles are present, proton and neutron, they are termed as nucleons. And the mass of an atom is concentrated at the nucleus. And there is outer nuclear part. So this outer nuclear part is called orbit or cell. So this is fixed path in which electrons revolve around the nucleus. Okay, they are called energy levels. Why they are called energy levels? Because they associated with certain amount of energy. Okay. Now remember this. Protons are positively charged particles. Electrons are negatively charged particles, and neutral particle without positive charge or without negative charge, that is zero charge, is neutron. Okay, so neutron is chargeless. So proton is written as P plus 1, that is plus 1 is charge for proton. Electron minus 1, charge for electron is minus 1. Neutron 0, so there is no charge. Got it? Okay. Am I clear to you or not? Okay. Now, after knowing this, let us move on to check the structure of atom. Okay, so since I've already told you atom, this is, I'll give you the atomic model first. Suppose this is nucleus. Okay, in the nucleus, protons and neutrons are there. Okay, this is nucleus, and there is outer nuclear part. This is orbit. This is what we called orbit. Okay, in the orbit, electrons are there like this. Okay, another orbit. First orbit, second orbit, similarly third orbit, fourth orbit, and so on. Got it? So, here electrons are present in the orbit. So, see. This is one orbit, so it has its own energy. That is why this is first energy level. This is second energy level. This is third energy level. Okay, as you go away from the nucleus, energy of the orbital increases. Okay, so this is K cell or first cell. दिस इज कॉल्ड एल सेल एम सेल एंड एल एम एन एंड सो ऑन दिस इज एन गॉट इट सो के सेल एल सेल एम सेल एन सेल सो दिस इज अ orbital picture of an atom so this is nucleus this is central part is nucleus in the nucleus proton and neutron are present and this is outer nuclear part orbit electrons are present which revolves around the nucleus got it or not okay so first energy level second energy level third fourth energy level k l m n got it now once this is done now we will move on to the two terms very 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 important atomic number and mass number some of you must have known this atomic number is number of protons okay or you can call it number of electrons actually while writing the definition of atomic number we write number of protons present in an atom yes or no This is or, okay. Why I am writing this number of electron or number of electron? Because in a neutral atom, in a neutral atom, total number of proton and total number of electrons always equal. Okay, that is why in a neutral atom, atomic number of protons and number of electrons are equal. That is why. Atomic number is number of proton or number of electron present in an atom. Got it? Mass number is total number of proton and neutron. Let me write. Okay. So what is mass number? Total number of proton and neutron in an atom. So mass number is the sum of protons and sum of the number of protons and the number of neutrons. And atomic number is number of proton present in an atom. Okay. And this atomic number and mass number. Atomic number is represented by letter capital Z, and this atomic mass number is represented as capital A. Okay. So generally suppose this x is an element or an atom atom or an element can be represented in this way okay here is z that is atomic number here is a that is mass number okay so atoms can be represented like this or element can be represent like this okay so this is the representation of atom so this is mass number this is atomic number okay I'll give you a very simple example. Suppose an element X is there, okay, with atomic number 12, mass number 24. Okay, so if you are asked to find number of protons, number of electrons, number of neutrons, you can easily do, since here. Mass number is how much? 12. Yes? Sorry. Mass number is 24. Atomic number is 12. Since atomic number is 12, So atomic number is the number of neutron. Sorry, number of proton present in an atom. Yes or no? So atomic number is number of proton present in an atom. So atomic number given is 12. Therefore, number of proton is always the atomic number, that is 12. Since this is neutral atom, number of proton and number of electrons are always equal. So number of electron is also 12. Yes. So now if we need to find number of neutrons, then what we need to do? Very simple. Mass number is what? Number of proton plus number of neutron. Proton is 12. Okay, so the neutron will be 24 minus 12. So this is 24 minus 12. This is equals to 12. Okay, are you getting this? Very, 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 very simple. Okay, so to find number of neutrons, small formula is there. Mass number minus number of protons. Okay. Understood this? Okay. I'll give you another example. Okay. One atom is there, that is chlorine, okay, with atomic number 17 and mass number 35. So this is mass number. So this is what? Mass number. So this is what? Atomic number. If this is atomic number, then number of proton is how much? 17. Mass number is 7, sorry, atomic number is 17, number of proton is also 17. If the number of proton is 17, then simply the number of electron is also 17. Now number of neutron, how much? Mass number minus atomic number, that is mass number is how much? 35 minus 17, this is 18. Yes or no? So in this way, you can find the number of proton, number of electron and number of neutron. Okay. So now we'll do electronic configuration. Okay. Okay. Before going into this electronic configuration, you must know the capacity of different orbitals. I have already told you orbitals, sorry, different orbits, not orbitals, orbits or shells. Okay, I have already told you electrons are present in the different orbit or cells. Yes or no? So they are associated with some kind of energy, that is energy level. Okay, so now there are so many, suppose this is nucleus, there are so many cells like this, see, K cell, L cell, M cell, K cell, L cell, M cell, N cell. Yes or no? So they have a certain capacity for the accommodation of electrons. So you cannot add electrons as much as you want in the cell. Okay, so there is some capacity for each of the cell. Okay, so the capacity of the cell can be determined by the formula called 2n square. Very simple. Okay, let us try to find the capacity of first cell, that is n is 1. For first cell, n is 1. Okay, so for K cell, let us write the capacity. 2 is there, n is 1 square. So 1 square is 1, that is 2. So the maximum number of electrons can be accommodated in K cell is 2. Okay, let us check for L cell. k first, l second. So n will be 2 square. 2 into 2 square is 4. That is equal to 8. So the maximum capacity of L cell is 8. So K cell can accommodate only 2 electrons. L cell can accommodate how many electrons? 8 electrons. Got it? Now let us check for M cell. That is for M cell. That is third cell. 2 is there. N is 3. That is for third cell. Square 2 into 9 is equals to 18. So M cell can accommodate how many electrons? 18 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, so the capacity of M cell is 18. Similarly, capacity of N cell you can easily calculate it. That is N cell is 4th cell. That is N is 4th square. 2 into 16 is equal to 32. So how many electrons can be accommodated in N cell? 32 electrons can be accommodated in the N cell. Okay. So try to understand this. Okay. Take a screenshot of this and try to find the capacity. Okay. So in our next class, we will do electronic configuration and how the electron are added in the different types of cells. We'll discuss that. Okay. So try to understand this. This formula is this capacity. Try to know the capacity for different cells. Okay. So next class we'll discuss about electronic configuration in more details. Okay. Thank you very much for today.